Welcome back to your class. This is my final talk about the topic on conceptual model. We can afford now the problem of the reactive transport model, numerical transport model, and going to some conclusion about the conceptual model used in contaminated site. But as a final step of our case study, and as a final step of what type other studies we can perform in such a large and complex contaminated site, we can lead to reactive transport model. In this case, we realized a very detailed reactive transport model about chlorine and solvents, and about in detail about 1,2-DCA contamination, as I mentioned you, which is represent more than 90% of chlorinated hydrocarbons detected in the sampling points. We start our numerical model, reactive numerical model, related to the three source area, or the three area where the plume of this type of contaminant had been found. And of course, we take into account, carefully take into account, as I mentioned more time during my lecture, the multi-level sampling, because the multi-level sampling give you an idea of the concentration with depth, which is very important, not only for, in general, for transport model, but is very is necessary if you want to go to a reactive transport model. As you can see, the main contaminants is related to the 1,2-DCA. The site-wide model is about 5 square kilometers with a lot of columns, rows, and layers, and of course the grid has a spacing, as a space gradually decreasing. And we also implemented a very small and local grid refinement in the southern eastern area of 0.1 square kilometer because of the necessity to go into detail to verify the fate of this transport mode. I want to tell you that reactive transport model at a site scale can be not very useful sometimes, because you need a lot of information, and it's very important, for example, to go along the transect, a 2D transect, for verifying to calibrate a reactive transport model. It's not an easy task. Only for plume number one, it was obtained a good fitting between observed and calculated concentration. In other cases, this was not possible because numerical oscillation induced by large grid cells. So you need also, in terms of model, a very, very strong modeling. The local grid refinement allowed to remove the numerical oscillation and to improve the fitting between calculated and observed concentration. So if you pass from a site-scale model to a very detailed and local model, we can have positive results in terms of calibration. In this case, on the left, you can see the measured concentration and the calculated concentration by the plant scale model and by the refining model. And also on the right side, you can see that the model is fits very well if you use a refining model respect to the plant model. So it's also a problem of upscaling. If you want to look in a detailed approach for reactive transport model, my suggestion is to go to the very, very small model with possibly with local grid refinement and lots of data in terms of multi-level sampling. I will show you quickly the results of this model. Of course, the grid refinements were done in a specific area to avoid numerical dispersion. If you look about concentration less than 1 microgram or the order of 1 microgram per liter, it's very important to avoid this numerical oscillation. So we move to a very detailed numerical model in this such a small area. So it's an upscaling refinement of your numerical grid. What about the plumes? Of course, the 1,2-DCA migrated downstream of the physical barrier before remediation. and the pump and treat recall the plumes and the saltwater wedge. This is the results of our model, which clearly indicated that the physical barrier act clearly as a real barrier to the diffusion of the contaminants downgrading to the shoreline. But if you have some concentration of these contaminants located downstream, downgrading of your hydraulic barrier and of course of your physical barriers, it's not easy to recover due to the presence of the stagnation zone. This is the results, graph results of our model, and in yellow-red are shown the calculated chloride contours, and of course the green representing the 1,2 DCA isosurface, and you can see also the physical barrier. This grid represents the physical barrier. If you imagine that the physical barrier has been placed in the area after that the contaminant has reached the downgradient area, we will see what's happened by the remediation plan, by the pumping activity after the pumping activity started, of course upgradient of the physical barrier. And this is the evolution with time due to the pumping activity, and you can see that if you don't have additional sources, due to the degradation rate, which is low in this case, but due to the pumping activity, also our reactive transport model indicate that we can observe a reduction of the concentration in the contaminant upgradient of the physical barrier. What about, I'm going back to see you better, to show you better, what about the situation downgradient of the physical barrier? The reduction doesn't really affect this part. There is only a small degradation rate, and of course downgradient there is no space for a good remediation. Upgradient of the physical barrier, the pumping wells are really active. Downgradient, the stagnation zone inhibits the possibility to reduce the concentration of the contaminants. We have only to wait for the natural attenuation in this case. But there is no migration to the shoreline, which is a positive, of course, in terms of the contamination widespread into the aquifer. I will show you another time this situation, and you can see that this is the final situation. What about calibration results of this reactive model? The multi-level piezometer upgrading and gradient to the physical barrier, where using a first order degradation rate very very low, we can see that the simulated and concentrated value are very similar with depth, both in the upgrading area and in the downgrading area. So it means that our model, very very local and 2D model, can be considered as representative of the groundwater flow and of the fate of these contaminants in this area. So the actual remediation strategy allowed for pollution control within the south boundary, and the degradation rate is in line with the literature value. The pumping scheme is increasing the saltwater wedge, but of course the physical barriers is not key in the aquifer. Modeling this complex, this is main finding in my opinion, modeling this complex hydrogeochemical problem require extensive grid refinement, a three-dimensional approach, but at the end you can have only a small area with good results in terms of modeling, where you have the large amount of data to be considered for calibration and validation. Finally, to sum up the results of this case study, and to go back to the topic of this talk, which is about the importance of the conceptual model and the possibility to build a real representative conceptual model in a contaminated site. This table resumed the activity we performed in these sites by chemical analysis, major ions, pollutant isotopes, and so on, by the integrate depth sampling, which means in the long screen monitoring wells only classical sampling by low flow system. And we also have the part related to the multi-level sampling, which include a lot of additional investigation. And of course we have the numerical modeling by groundwater flow and non-reactive transport model. If you look at this integrated methodological approach, we can also identify source and plume location by some of the activity, both in the classic way or in the multi-level sampling way. And of course, seawater intrusion identification can be investigated. The contamination origin and sources can be related to their causes, but mainly by using multi-level sampling. Degradation process also can be taken into account, can be investigated, but if you use multi-level sampling, if you remain on a classical approach, the results you can have can be significant, but your conceptual model cannot be considered a very detailed and a very performed one. So I suggest to use the classical approach in sampling and analysis for a preliminary conceptual model, which can be useful for a flow modeling, for example, flow numerical model. But I strongly recommend to refine your conceptual model by using multi-level system, which really help by the use also of isotope technique in building a solid and detailed and consistent conceptual model, refined one, which can really be transformed in non-reactive or in reactive mathematical models, which allow you to preview what could be the effect of your remediation techniques you are ready to implement in this site. So to sum up and to close my lecture, I can state that the conceptual model is necessary to drive monitoring a remediation plan. And you can use a preliminary one. But the final conceptual model does not exist, but it needs progressive refinement both in space but upscaling approach and in time by monitoring data to review the model. So it's important to underline that the conceptual model can be improved, but it remains a schematic classification, a schematic approach of the real situation, the natural situation, which can be very complex. The classical investigation can lead to a preliminary conceptual model, but it cannot be sufficient if you want to really go into detail and want to implement a good remediation plan. So the modeling in terms of flow, transport and reactive has to be used as a tool to improve. And of course, for calibrate, you can calibrate. But I really think that validating your conceptual model by modeling can be a risk. Sometimes you can have positive results, but you can also have some misleading. So what to do? The multi-level and additional investigation are recommended to improve and to independently validate your refined conceptual model. You can use independent approach like the isotope one I show you in this lecture for improving your model and of course for independently validate. In this case, you can come back to the numerical model and you can perform also transport modeling and reactive transport modeling if you need or if you can. So thank you for your attention, and I hope that this lecture was useful for you.